what I wanted to do is actually go through a little bit and kind of design this place. What's up, people? I'm Zoe, back on Vanilla Minecraft in my super crazy awesome world. Customized and everything, just for me. Now, I've torn it all out. Now, don't worry, we're not going to get into it. We're going to get into it, but I'm not going to go through everything with you. I'm going to build the majority of this off camera, but I think this looks crazy. You know what the room looked like before, but this is everything that I had to change about it just to fit this design in. And the design didn't even work, which is why I tore it out in the first place. It's not something that was fixable. It wasn't. I had so many issues with it. One, the water stream in the middle of the second floor, or the first floor, how we kind of had a water stream going through where we had to walk. That was terrible. It was just a terrible design. That was on me. That one was definitely me. I have to design around that, and I don't know how to do it. Might end up only having one floor of this. I don't know yet. But in any case, that was one thing that played into factor. Also, the villagers kept getting stuck. They would go across, and they would just get stuck in the middle of a water stream. They would just stop. I feel like the design doesn't work. SC Petty's design, it doesn't work for me. I don't know if it's a thing, a directional thing. You have to move east to west. You have to do this. You have to do that. It didn't work for me. I don't know why, but it didn't. So I've actually redesigned a new villager trading stall. I made my own, and it's actually a lot easier to make. It's less resource intensive, it's faster, and best of all, it doesn't require a minecart. You can just let the villagers go in as they are, because since I want the space in between them anyway, it works out perfectly that way. The only way to get a side-by-side villager training hall, like SC Petty's design, is to use the minecarts, like he said. But something about the water streams and minecarts with villagers in them, just for some reason, they stop somewhere. So yeah, I can't do that. But I didn't want to do that anyway, so we're good. But yeah, I have a new design, and I'm just going to go ahead and put everything together. I'm going to throw it all in there, and yeah, it should be okay. Hopefully, it'll be fine. We're going to do some stuff. Away. They haven't been resolved because I didn't fix the problems, but I did redesign it. Then as you can see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7, 7, 7. Same number of villagers on each level, so we have the same number of everything there, which is really good because I think it's a good number. I think it's a pretty good number. But this thing does have its own problems aside from the design change, which actually I like better than the other one. I'm sure you guys probably do as well. It has its own problems, but it's kind of expected. When I designed this, 100% my design, this whole thing, I didn't see it on a YouTube video, and I don't care where you saw what. I don't believe you, because I made this, and I'm very, very, very proud of it, so don't try to take it away from me. It ain't gonna work. This is mine. I spent hours in creative on this, trying to design something, and I'm keeping it. It's mine. Anyway. This thing is ridiculous, though, too. It's really, really cool. First and foremost, what we have is the minecart still comes down here. And all the redstone blocks and blah, 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 power tracks are just so the minecart will actually return on its own without a villager. That's why we have so many of them. It was kind of ridiculous getting it to do that. But this guy right here will kick them out onto the block right here. The water source will push them out all the way over here. Now, this is one little trickster thing that we have to get around. It's a workaround right now, and for now, this cell will always be empty. Because the water source runs out, and I don't have a way to repeat it without causing problems. And I'll explain that here in a minute, because we have another problem way further. But, it should only be one per. It should only be one per side. So really, we have six per, so we have 6, 12, so we have 24 villagers rather than 28. But it's fine. And like right here, it runs out. So what can you do? What in the world? What? That's when you have to go ahead and basically put in a sign. I'm going to have to, I don't know, do another one right here just so it extends further. Like I feel like, because this is where the water source ends all on its own. I need it to go like one block further. So do I put another one in here? I know you can't see. I apologize. Let's put one here and one here. And the reason for this is just to let the water go further. Why did I... No, they're fine. That's fine. That's actually what I was like, well, no, the water stopped. Why? Because it was supposed to, Zog. You're fine. And then this guy will go further down to here, and that way we should be okay. I don't know if I need it. Yeah, I did kind of need that, though, to be honest. And the reason for that is because I needed to stop at a fence gate, not one block short, because then the water source would kind of go over two blocks. And it's not the biggest deal in the world. It would still work, but I prefer if I can make it not do that in a hidden way, because you see it's kind of sort of showing in the glass area here, but it's not completely there, and it's better. I don't know. Anyway, but I have to do this to repeat the water, and some of these guys are just going to remain empty, one per side, which is really, really unfortunate. But let me show you this, first of all. So I hold shift. Am I going to fall off the edge? I'm not. Good. So what we have... Actually, you know what? Let's take this to my creative mode where I designed the daggone thing so I can show you that way, since this side is already put together. So this is the design. Well, this part right here is kind of the design when it's done. I had to break it apart so I could middle click to actually take some of these resources. But this is the entirety of the system. It's a very, very simple system. Okay, it uses 2 observer blocks, 2 sticky pistons, 1 fence gate, 1 button, and a few redstone. Like 3 redstone, I think. And then the rest of whatever kind of building blocks. 4 redstone. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 4 redstone. 2 sticky pistons, a fence gate, 2 observer blocks, and a button. Like, and a trapdoor. And a string. I always forget everything. Anyway. So, the way it works is that the observer blocks, they observe things. Like, it's basically a block update detector. But it's not really, it watches for different things. Some things trigger it, some things don't. But the bottom line is that string does when it gets on and when you come off. So what happens is this guy sees it, sends out a pulse. Lighting of redstone is another thing that the observers can see. So once this is lit by this guy, therefore when the mob falls right on top of this guy, he sees it. He sees the redstone and sends power into this. Now the power is short enough. Let me see if I can actually do this in a way. Yeah, I can use string. So if I throw a string here, you'll see, basically, even though they're sticky pistons, the time that these guys are active is so short that this block isn't fully settled in yet before this thing starts to retract, which ends up in it leaving it there. And in the next iteration that I'm about to show you, this block is going to be sent out and it's not going to be fully seated in its new position before this guy has to start retracting. So it's going to retract without it and it's going to leave it there. And then this guy, since he's already here, he's not going to be moved. Therefore, the sticky piston can pick it back up and retract it. Basically, what you get is this cool little switch. When this guy's out, this guy's in. When this guy's out, this guy's in. So it just kind of switches. And you'll kind of see that here, bloop, where it kind of just picks one up and the other is kind of gone. We'll see it again, bloop, just like that. You see that? It's a cool, nifty little feature, and it was actually one way to do a monostable circuit or RS NOR latch inventive ways to do things like that, and I've used that kind of a concept here. So what happens is basically this fence gate, when it's open and this block is retracted, the hole is here. So the villager is going to come in with the water source like you saw in the other thing. They're going to fall down in here, hit the string, all this system is going to run. The block is then going to be pulled over its head. This fence gate is going to be retracted, allowing the water stream to flow over this block that will now be here and continue to the next cell. Hopefully you understood all that, because we're going to go back to the overworld now. Or overworld? My other, the survival, awesome, crazy custom world. Alright, so this guy is now functional. At the very least, I have all of the water in here. I have plenty of people trapped in here. We can go and take a look. And we have a librarian there. But we do have a few nitwits. So I wanted to show you what happens when I press this button. First of all, let me go down a little bit. Here? Yeah, I see a water stream, right? I should be able to catch up to him, no problem. So we have a nitwit, for example. Boop. Oh, look at you. Oh, I put it on the wrong side of the block. Crap, it was supposed to be towards me. It was supposed to be on this side of the block. All of them were, actually. Because if I put it on this side of the block and they aren't going down, I just have to punch them. But now I have no way to bring them towards me. So I had to put it on the other side of the block. Crap-o. We have to go down and break it. That's fine. I'm going to have to do some... all of these villagers are about to get flushed. But let me show you what happens when that is a thing. There it is. It opens back up. And he goes all the way... I got that trap door, right? Good. Oh, man. I can't believe all of these villagers are about to die. They're about to get flushed down here. I know it's really, really, really dark. I apologize. Here, I'll put some light down. This area doesn't need to be lit up, though. That's why I didn't put any torches down originally. There's no point because there's water on the ground. We're not going to get any mob spawns. And even if there was, it doesn't matter because they're all going to be pushed off and they're all going to go and die anyway. So this guy goes along in here. He can take as long as he wants. It doesn't really bother me. I'll push him along a little bit because right now I care just because, you know, video and stuff. And then he goes around a corner. And then he sees his glooming death like, oh, no. No, he didn't. No. Oh, my. Oh, this is not going to be good. Ah, boom. And he's dead. Goodbye, villager. So we're good to go on that front with those things. But I do need to go through now and basically dispose of all of the villagers. And that's not, it's terrible. Oh, also the runoff from the top level, or the bottom level, rather. The top level goes to the bottom level, all the way on the other side, and then the bottom level comes all the way over here. So if for some reason we have too many villagers, then they'll run off the edge and bam, they'll come down into this thing, they'll just fall right down into the water and it's not a problem. Now, you might notice that the top level disposal system actually drops into the intake of the second floor. Let me re-say that so you actually know what I'm talking about. The disposal system of the top floor dumps into the dispersion system of the second, the bottom floor. So these guys, when I'm like, hey, no, I don't want you anymore, they're just going to drop into here. But under normal circumstances, these guys are going to be filled. So they're going to go all the way around, they're going to fall, and they're going to get disposed of. And in some cases, I'm going to have, say, a librarian up top here that I want to be saved, that I want to keep. I can empty out a villager down here and literally move him from the second floor to the first floor by using this system. So it's really, really cool. It's actually, it allows me very minimal organization of the villagers. Now, granted, I can't take one of these guys and move them up top or blah, 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 but I can do a little bit, just a tiny itty bitty bit, which is pretty cool. But today we're actually not going to focus on stuff like that. I'm going to take care of these. Actually, you know what? Let me tell you a little bit of the other stuff that I need to do, just in case I need you to remind me what they are in the future, because we got to fix some stuff. One is the trapdoors, which I plan on doing like now. Two is that the minecart system is a little wonky. The cart doesn't always come back. So we're going to have to work on the cart system, which I'm going to end up redesigning. Right now, it just goes all the way down there, bounces off a wall, and comes all the way back to right here. This cart actually flips this track over, so it actually allows it to go all the way up there rather than to the left. And then on the way back, it just skips over the track and lands just fine there. So it works about 80% of the time. But sometimes it gets stuck down there, and I think it's because the villagers are, like, pressing up against it or trapping it or whatever, and it's just kind of a thing. But I'll have to work on that in the future. That's a thing. And also, the ones, basically, that I can't fill because the water, I have to repeat the water, so it actually allows the villagers to skip right over them. I need to work out something like that. So those water sources are only put out after this one is filled, or after this one is filled, I'm sorry. So basically, right now, the water source wouldn't be there because this guy isn't filled yet. And as soon as he's filled, as soon as this is triggered, then it drops the bucket as well. And that way, it'll actually continue how it's supposed to, and everything would be fine. But all I really need to do is the tick that is triggered from the string, I need to hook it up to a dispenser. And doing so should, in theory, make it work exactly as I need it to. But like I said, today we're not going to work on that. I have a design concept in here for this that I really want to play with, including this corner and these corners and this corner. Pretty much the entire room is almost designed in my head. But I need to get it down, and I don't know how exactly to do that. But we're going to start with a few things, but I do need to lay out some groundwork first. Just some basic things that I think should be here, and then I'm going to explain the overall story and theme of this place. All right, so I've done a little bit of work, and I have to show you this. Look. Look at the thing. KK, I'm back. Achievements. Achievements. Catistics. Open to networks. Options. It's really cool. And this one right here is just normal because it's a mod thing. But if you go into what your speak, you go into here in your language and you go to lolcat, which is, it's hilarious. Force unicat font, no. It's really, really funny. Like, everything has its own little name and stuff. Like, this pack frozen water. Gray rock. Rock. Oh my goodness. Dark oak wood planks. Oh my goodness, it's hilarious, Bose. Power 5, never break 3, flame, forevers! it's hilarious. Broken level? Oh my goodness, it's hilarious. But we're playing with that. Anyway, I put it on for a little while. It's really, really hilarious to me. But what I wanted to do is actually go through a little bit and kind of design this place. Now first what I've done is I cleared out the corners. I was going to keep them in. That was going to be part of the design because the top farm, the carrot farm we have actually has those kinds of corners, and I wanted to mimic it completely. But the idea that I have is actually a lot cooler. Well, it should be. But here is where our chests are going to be, and I'm thinking about putting the button over here too just because it's a lot closer to that thing. But I still need to hook up the dispenser to automatically do the minecart. And then I need on the other end to break the minecart and send it all the way back. And yeah, it's a thing. But that's how I want to handle that situation. For now, though, we're not going to worry about it. So I'll manually go ahead and grab villagers when I need to. I actually ran out of villagers. I don't have enough. But I did break all of the trapdoors. That's why these guys are not filled and these guys are, is because I just started to fill the top row back up when I ran out of villagers. So I still need a bunch more, but they're probably almost there now. Anyway, yes, this is going to be our chests. We're going to have, I don't know why this one's 3 back. Why are you 3 back? Doesn't make much sense to me. Hold on. Let's fix that right now. You two, just because I don't want to waste the blocks. Don't want to waste the blocks. I don't want to waste stacked rocks. Stacked rocks are too awesome. Anyway, so yeah, these are gonna be the chests. We're gonna have like carrots and beets and potatoes and I don't know, something else to trade with, sugar cane or paper or something. Whatever. And I want to add more into. I might be able to add in more here and over here. If I get really desperate, I can... No, that's about it. I don't add more somewhere else. I don't know. Hopefully that's about all we need. Anyway, it doesn't really matter. For now, we're just going to have those, though, because it'll be a while before we get there, and it's really not that hard to add another row. At least one more row. But the theme that we're going for here is that these people, right? And we still have our main guy. He's going to be like the foreman, right? They were tasked with coming out here and setting up shop in a cave. All right, so in this cave... they're just now starting to morph it over. So the floor, like this stuff here, is like what they've built up so far. And these guys have their little trading stalls and blah, blah, blah. And we're going to have bits of the floor are going to be like wood, like you know, like it was civilized. Like they've been digging it out and transforming it into a civilized place. But they're not done yet. So in the corners over here and over here, we're going to have, like, this huge, like, packed ice. Or wait, what are you called? You are packed frozen water. Where did you come from, dude? And where the heck did you get a friggin' sword? You spawned somewhere, and I don't know where it was. Or you dropped from somewhere. I don't know. That's weird. Anyway. So we have these, like, basically crystals... that are, well, it's kind of like an ice cave, right? So I guess it is still like ice, but, and I want this to be like super tall. So I actually need to get up there pretty high, not super tall, but like, I don't know. I want it to go up to about there. I just can't get that high at the moment. Super fast breaking, man. Super, super fast. So we're going to go up to probably like this, actually break off the corner. I'm glitching. Look, I'm glitching. Watch. I'm gonna place down a torch. Ready? Holy crap, you're packed ice. All the hacks is... No, not really. Anyway, so yes, now we have this. We can kind of climb up to the top-ish. Like so. I want it to go up to here. We're going to go ahead like this. Now, I want it to be mostly tall. I don't want it to be a fat crystal. I want it to be like a thinner one. Not like thin, but you know what I mean. We're going to go up to there. Yeah. A little randomness. Randomness. Nope, too much. Don't like it. Okay. How's this look? How's this looking? It's too fat. All right, let's chop this down. We'll do maybe one couple over here. We'll spread it out along the wall more so than just, you know, like kind of breaching this area over here so it looks a little bit better like this. Yeah, there we go. That's better. Yeah, that's almost exactly what was in my head. Almost. So now I need another one, which I only have one stack. I mean, granted, I have like a whole double chest full of the packed ice. That's not a worry. I just only have a stack with me here. So we're going to do another one of these things. And again, I need it to be super tall. Eat, then eat. You happy now? Hopefully. Hold down the button. There we go. How tall? Couple more. Yeah, that'll work. Whee! Okay. So, and then we'll have these guys. Now, the other thing that I want to do with this packed ice stuff is actually something over in the chest area. I think it's going to be pretty cool if we can actually do this properly. I don't know. Is that... I think this is too far out. I don't want you there. You're gonna go up two more. You're gonna go up one. Is that too much? I feel like that's too much here, but maybe I just need to blend it a little better. Oh, that is way too uniform. What happened? Where'd the randomness go? How's that look? Is that, nope, that's almost exact. If I broke this one and this one, it would be completely symmetrical. What is happening to me? No, 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 more no, all the no. All right, let's do this. Leave that alone. We'll build you up one. That's too short. There. And I need you to not be symmetrical. That's pretty good. That's okay. I think it needs to be a little taller, actually. I want a couple more blocks here. And these guys need to go. I wish I had my enderpearls. I really need to go back to the end to get some more enderpearls. Let's pillar up with something that I know is not part of the build. So I can actually see what to tear back down. Here we go. All right, so let's go. I know it's dark. It's super, super dark. You guys can't see anything. Packed frozen water. We're going to go one there, one here, and one here like this. Oh, crap. I need to take that down. No, I don't. We're going to have lighting up there. I just don't know how yet. Not sure exactly what. Oh, yep. See, that's what. I'm not exactly sure. Yeah, totally, totally. It's exactly. That's exactly what I wanted. Okay, I need to go get more frozen water. I actually called it by its proper name without trying to be funny about it. Frozen. I actually called it. I say proper name, but proper name for this language. I totally called it frozen water. It was kind of funny. Oh, glitchy. You got. Okay, well, I guess I'm sleeping. And technically, I'm still on 111.2 or whatever, so we'll be able to see some of that stuff. But anyway, there we go. Also, you might notice that I haven't really run out of rockets, and that's because no matter the time of day, I can go anywhere to find creepers. And every now and then, I just go and hunt for them. Like, there's two there, there's one here, and I can actually walk back and forth on this platform alone. And I can even jump across here underneath as well. And I can literally go there at any point during the day and find, like, in a matter of 10 minutes, I can go and get, like, 15 creepers. And it's not a huge amount of rockets. I mean, I'm not going to fill up a double chest that way, but I'm not going to run out either. So we're going to be okay. But it is a pain in the butt. We're going to have to go get some kind of a creeper farm thing going soon. Very, very, very soon. Anyway, so with it. Oh, right. I wanted to do this. How does one do what I want to do? I guess I'd have to tear this back out, but then the water rushes out again, and I don't really want to do that. I wanted this stuff to kind of, like, surround it. Like, they kind of dug through the crystal to get to their storage area, right? But I don't think it's... I don't know if that's going to look right, though. And it kind of, you know, it's still kind of coming over a little bit here. I can't have that one there, though. You know, like, I have to dig away some of this, but it still has to look like it was dug away. I can't look like a non-crystal. You know, like, they actually dug it. I can't. This is going to be difficult, man. It's going to be hard. So hard. Bring you a little taller. I'll carve a new hole into here if I have to. Let's go here and here. And then we can kind of get in there a little bit. And we kind of have access to our chests. Which is kind of interesting. I don't know. Tell me what you guys think about this one. Because this one's a little weird. This one's different. And I'm not sure about that guy. I do love these guys, though. It's really cool how, you know, it's kind of like in the corners. Like, they're worried about the main areas more so than anything else, right? So, it's pretty cool. Now, this is... It's almost like these crystals are impossible to get rid of. Like, they're the hard things to mine. They're the hard things to clear out. So, they didn't worry about all of them. They just worried about enough to get where they needed to go. And they left the rest alone, which is kind of how that is. It's the kind of theme that I'm going for, right? Miners just trying to set up shop kind of thing. But I do need to set up some kind of flooring in here. And I don't exactly know how to do it. I'm not sure what kind of floor I want. But I tell you what I do know is that most of this is actually going to be... And we're going to try to make this as random as I can. Ooh. Oh. Whoa. Where'd you come from, man? Jeez. Don't scare me like that. Give me some regular stuff here so I don't fall in a hole. This is going to be trouble, man. Total trouble. All right, let's go like this. I'm going to try to dig randomly, but basically, overall, we're going to be going towards the other... It's going to be like a diagonal-shaped thing, right? So we do this, like a Sioux, and then we'll go over a little bit like that. Yeah, so that's... Yeah, it's kind of random like that. It's really good. It's not a perfect arch. It's not... You know, perfectly diagonal or anything like that. And this is where snow is going to start. And this is like the floor of the cave. You know, one of those really cold, dark, deep caves that, well, granted, I've never been in one in real life, so I don't know if it's a true thing or not. But you see them in movies and stuff where you go through and you have like the Yeti cave. It's all covered in snow at the bottom, right? Which I guess wouldn't really be a thing. Caves are probably semi-warm inside. Because they're closed space, they're not really like access to the sky or whatever, so having snow inside a cave is kind of not real. I don't know. Anyway, it doesn't matter. We're gonna have it anyway. So I'm gonna clear out this floor here all the way back to the entrance, and it's all gonna be snow on the ground right here. This is all gonna be wood. I don't know if I'm gonna make it all the same kind of wood or if I'm gonna mix it up, but it needs to be some kind of wood going on here, and I need to get started on it. Oh, there are a few more things that I still need to do, including the roof and the walls, but we're getting close. We are getting close. Now, this right here is going to be the platform that we stand on to do the trades for the top level. It's going to be filled in with glass, probably the white glass that we used in here, because I think it'll work. It'll be pretty good. It's going to look all right. And I still need a way up to this, too. So we need to do the walls. I need to find a way up to these guys. And I need to fix the little issues I already mentioned earlier in the video. Don't let me forget those. But I need to add those to a to-do list. I need to make a to-do list in this world. Andy does that. Andrew Indy, he's got a link down in the description. He's got his own single-player series. It's going on for a long, long time. 70-some episodes, so now. For right now. Wow. Yeah, so go check that out. But he's got a to-do list in his series. And I really need to have one of those. But anyway, so I had the design here. This is the wood floor. I don't know if I want to keep it all dark oak like it is now. I'm not sure. I don't know. But I kind of bled it up into the sides. So it looks like this is where they're at right now, right? They've finalized this area here, minus the little crystal in the corner that, I don't know, maybe they thought it was a nice little attraction or souvenir or something, something. But they're still working on everything else. So all this is going to be snow from this line over and from this line over. And the ceiling is going to have, I don't know, something else. The other thing that I wanted to play with, really quick, I don't want this episode to go too long, but I wanted to get some snow levels, snow layers in here. And what we can do is actually start piling these up a little bit. And, oh, I can't put snow on slabs? Can I put them on full blocks? Oh, bummer, that's a pain. I mean, I guess it doesn't have to go on. It'll still kind of look like it's being overtaken a little bit, even though I can't actually put it there. You know, just kind of coat the border around this. And on the edges over here, kind of make it taller and have some kind of snow. So it looks like they're actually battling, you know, the snow situation over here for domain of the cave, kind of. Does that make sense? Hopefully it makes sense. I don't know. That's what I feel like would happen if they were digging things up, right? If they were pushing back the snow, it would start to pile up right in the edge. And it would start to look something along those lines, which really looks pretty cool, I think. Now, it'll be a little weird running over it and blah, blah, blah. But again, it looks good. And to me, that's more important. So it's cool. But I do have to finalize this. We're not going to do this in the next episode. I think it's definitely time that we move on. I've spent 3 or 4 episodes now in just villager stuff. Granted, one was a carrot farm, one was a villager breeder, and 2, I think, were the villager hall. So, yeah, I think it's 4 episodes. It's enough. We need to move on. But I am going to be slowly working on this. Eventually, we're going to come in here and just be like, oh, look, it's done. Oh, yay, woohoo, all right, and then move on. So it's pretty good. So get your looks in here. Send your suggestions to this video and all that other good stuff, because you may not actually see me working in here too much, at least not for a while. So it is what it is. But if you liked the video, don't let that like button get lonely and subscribe for some more. Check out the Patreon and donation link down below. Thank you for watching. Do what you do, and I will see you next time. Peace out, peeps. Come to think of it, this is actually a really long episode.